Hello everyone, we are very happy to see you all here today. And this is our great pleasure to welcome Dr. Salam Abdel Fattah, Engineer Mohammed Nafas, and our supervisor, Engineer Baya Shakur. And we are delighted to present you our research project about 3D scanner that is prepared by me, Omar Mari, and my partners, Mariam Shahadi and Andy Shurba. The main topics that will be discussed in our presentation are introduction about reverse engineering and 3D scanner, methodology, analysis of scanning high-level objects, trial of scanning, problem and challenges, and finally conclusion and future vision.
Now, reverse engineering. Reverse engineering is the process of duplicating an existing part or product without drawing or computer model. Process of reverse engineering. We have the real object, we have 3D scanner, 3D scanner will scan the real object, and get STL file that can go to 3D printer, I get another object that looks like the real object. 3D scanner. 3D scanner is the device that scans and collects data from the real object in XYZ. They convert that data into 3D object from many processes. Now, the standard will take into account in building how 3D scanner. Object which run a scan, required accuracy and resolution, the speed of our 3D scanner, our scanning environment, and our budget. Methodology. Let's go to electrical bar, sensing element. The most important part of our 3D scanner. We use IR sensor working with triangulation method, which is created with CMOS detector. Let's know triangulation method. Triangulation method is triangle, this triangle. This triangle has fixed distance between the sensor and detector, and the relation between the desired distance and reflection angle, which is defined by the detector. CMOS detector is an array of pixels. Each pixel compares light format into voltage separately, so data here is taken as digital, 0 or 1. Features of our IR sensor, it measures range between 4 to 15, doesn't affect with light, it has two-way for connection, digital IFC or analog output, high precision measurement, low power, and maximum response is 40 milliseconds. Our controller is Arduino Uno. We use each brake to drive stepper's motor. We have 20 massive stepper's motor. One of them is rounding shaft for rotating blade, and the other is integrated with power screw for moving sensor vertically. And ticket diagram. Arduino controls each brake that drives stepper motor, and we have IR sensor which is connected with Arduino by digital IPC wave. Now, mechanical part with Maria.
Now, I will talk about the mechanical part of our structure. This figure shows the mechanical structure of our 3D scanner designed by SOLIDWORKS. This closed position of our scanner, open position for it. Here we put the sensor, and here the power screw used to control the distance manually between the object and the sensor along these rods. Here bearings to hold all loads, so the motor will rotate under no load, and the rotating and this circular bath used to achieve the stability to the rotating blade. The principle of our scanner follows this sequence: the rotating blade turns one step, then IR sensor reads the distance. This portion will loop until complete one revolution. After that, axial stepper motor will turn, making IR sensor rises up according to the required resolution, repeating this sequence until completing scanning all the objects. Depending on this picture that taken from IR characteristic, and for satisfying the specification of the electro-optical technology, and by assuming that we have a cylindrical object with radius of 15 cm and 7 cm away from the IR sensor, IR beam will cover about 1 cm square of the surface area of the object. On the other hand, circular area element is about 0.1 cm square for each step of the rotating blade. So we can scan the object with relatively high accuracy and resolution. We use CNC machine to cut the parts of our scanner. We use PVC foam with density of 700 and acrylic with density of 1,200. Now I want to start with the software and the programming of our project. We use MATLAB to control Arduino and to process data. I will start with the graphical user interface, which makes our scanner friendly so anyone can use it easily. He needs only to enter the parameters of the graphical user interface. The parameters are height of the object in millimeter, then choose the resolution if it's low, medium, or high. The resolution represents the distance that the IR sensor moves vertically after completing one revolution of the rotating blade. If he chooses the low resolution, that means the IR sensor will move 0.96 millimeter. On the other hand, high resolution means the vertical distance equal 0.32 millimeter. Then he need to decide if the surface with top or not. After that, the time needed for scanning can be calculated by clicking on this button. And by clicking on start button, the process scanning will start. After that, data will be processed using MATLAB according to this loop. And after processing data, the STL file will be saved on the server.
So what happened to the data that collected from buyer sensor? After scanning process is completed, all data will be saved in global matrix, then insert to the processing MATLAB code, starting with invert all reading data respect to the center of rotation, then filter all IR reading, then arrange them in one matrix. Each row in this matrix represents one revolution reading, and each column represents one z-height. After that, this theta and our polar coordinate convert to Cartesian coordinate. Then give a thickness for the surface, and finally, an STL file is produced. Now, our scanner is ready to use. So we started with scanning an ideal cylindrical object with radius of 16.4 centimeter and has a white surface color. We did that to determine the accuracy and after we scanned this cylindrical object, we selected randomly 10 revolutions of reading and analyzed them. We did two types of analysis. The first one to determine the accuracy of our scanner by comparing the ideal circle, 16.4 centimeter, and with the practical reading. As shown in this figure, the orange one is the ideal circle, and the blue one is the practical reading of revolution number 10. And as we noted, the maximum error between them is about 1 millimeter. The second type of analysis to check the stability of our reading over the height. So we comparing the practical reading of revolution number 10 and revolution number 100. And as we notice from this figure, they have a quite similar reading. So we can conclude that our scanner has a good accuracy. Trial scanning. The first trial for a cylindrical object. And this object is symmetric about the center of rotation. This is the result. Second trial to check the ability of our scanner to scan a corner, and we scan a hexagonal object. Third trial for a symmetric elliptical object. And we scan a jar. This jar has a height of 100 millimeter, and it took 3 hours. The last scanning trial for a complicated toy that have a complicated detail. This toy has a height of 150 millimeter, and it took 4 hours.
And challenging in our project. The first one is achieving the stability of the rotating plate. We did that first by using the most appropriate way to connect between the shaft and the rotating plate. We used the box, but that didn't work as a result of the friction force between the box and the rotating plate. After that, we used this capital wedge spring, but that reduced the stability of the rotating plate as a result of the spring. Finally, we printed this capital wedge chamfer, and that gave us the desired result. We also can increase the stability of the rotating plate by using this circular valve with wheels and by choosing the most suitable IR reading for each step. After that, the second problem that we faced, making IR sensor looking directly at the center of the rotating plate and calibration the IR sensor by measuring the real distance and correct the equation of the sensor to achieve that distance. After that, we faced graphical user interface problem. That represented in that we cannot control the Arduino environment using graphical user interface. The solution of this problem by controlling Arduino using MATLAB. The solution helped us to improve our scanner by getting rid of using SD card. So now data transfer manually after completing scanning process.
Yeah.
Now, of course, the biggest challenge about doing this kind of besides using IR technology is our budget. Our budget is about $400, so it's too cheap compared with the other scanners in the market, which cost thousands of dollars. The overall budget for 3D scan divided into the cost of structure, mechanical part, electrical part, and then the total is 1270 shekel. And final with Omar, conclusion.
So our scanner can work well because of its environment condition, and it can be easily used by anyone by adding a graphical user interface feature. In our project, we focus to improve our scanner in terms of accuracy, resolution, and speed. So it can scan any object in accuracy of 1 millimeter and with reasonable speed. Our future work is to build a commercial 3D scanner, and that can be achieved by replacing an IR sensor with laser range finder sensor that integrated with CMOS camera. And thank you for watching our show. And we want now to show you a video.
As we can see here, our scanner can be carried as a handbag. Now we're preparing the scanner for scanning the picture. He need only to connect the board to the scanner. Now we control the distance manually between the sensor and the object. Now our scan already changed. The graphical user interface parameter, the height 5 millimeters. We choose the low resolution and the top close top surface. The time needed for scanning 3 minutes. By clicking on the start button, the scanning will start. The rotating blade rotate 1 revolution. After that, the axial stepper motor rises up 0.96 according to low resolution. Now the file editing. The STL file, cylindrical object with top with 5 millimeter height. Finally, I would like to thank everyone who shared us these wonderful moments, starting with our supervisor, Dr. Baha Shakur. This project wouldn't have been done without your help, encouragement, and support, so thank you. All thanks and respect to all staff members who taught us during 4 years.
Staff.
Especially you, Dr. Salameh. Yeah. Special special thanks to our beloved family.
وانتهى الكنافة.
And our friends.
لا هيك كثير والله.
Giving us of themselves in countless way. And to him, to him, my father, who giving me happiness in countless way. In glint of his eyes only I can see my success. والحمد لله رب العالمين.